Tony Wright, everybody. Yeah. It's four of us on this tour right now. It's me and Paul, when he is doing front of house. We're driving in a rented Peugeot. What is it, 206, is it? What is it? Fucking awesome, man. We've driven, where did we drive from? It was, I think it was like Bristol with one tank of diesel. It's fucking awesome. And then Dario and Tony are sharing the other vehicle, which is equally as prestigious. So that's how we roll, guys. Thank you so much for coming tonight, man. Holy crap. Holy crap indeed. Okay, I can turn on my shit. Hang on a second.
Right. I know, right? Okay, check this out. Here I go.
Get
on with you. Yeah!
Okay, so I'm walking around backstage there today, and I'm trying to put together how I feel, because every day when we start this up, I'm trying to get sort of an idea of where I'm at and what the day's going to entail and all these sorts of things. And today's an interesting one, because I keep thinking to myself before I go on stage, I'm like, I'm going to forget how to do this, you know? That's my first thought backstage. I'm like, I don't remember what I'm doing. I don't remember what songs I'm going to play. I don't remember how to interact with other humans. I mean, what do you say, right? So I thought, we'll start talking about what you feel about Scotland, talk about what you feel about Glasgow, and this place is really cool, and I really like it here. I did realize I forgot my iPad backstage, so can I take 2 seconds here? I'll keep playing, so just you guys talk amongst yourselves. And someone walked in. No? That was you? Hey, how's it going, buddy? All right. And Heather got me this. It's like a little thing that makes owl sounds. And a wolf. It's Halloween. Here, what's this one? This would be it. Thank you. myself like, wow, for once, that's great. I don't have to be there for the family get-together. Like, where's my head? That's so weird. Why is that? All right. Dude, can you say something as loud as you can say?
I love you!
There we go. All right. So, and please, you, can you say something super quiet for me? You're going to have to hold on a second. What was that again?
It's your birthday? What's your name? Jenny?
It's like a time warp. All right. So, let's start with that, everybody. Happy birthday!
Happy birthday, dear Jenny.
So you got, see, we got these poozers here in the church. That's a good start, right? To try and do acoustic shows is strange in the first place, but to bring along your shrieking ball sacks makes it a little easier. So I think how we should probably start from this point is to sort of entertain the fact that we do have a sort of sci-fi element in this beautiful venue, and let's call out a little bit of the Ziltoidian fervor. What do you say? And if it's not fervorous, if that's even a verb or something like that, one of those adjective verb facts, yeah, protagonist, antagonist, I always, yeah, I'm going to go with verb. If ziltoiding is not a verb, then poosering I'm sure will be after this song, all right? So picture, if you will, in your mind's eye, a space captain, alone, a vessel amongst the infinite cosmos. Captain Spectacular speaks. Yourself. There's no question. Really? You got friends? I got used to do when you were younger. But the process of making music for me is simply about plowing through those sorts of experiences, which I have no idea how to quantify, writing music about it in order to objectively look at it after the fact and say, okay, that's what you were. Okay, well, enough of that shit. What's next? What's your life goal? I don't want to be this neurotic guy talking to myself. I want to play. All right, so... Thank you. Sky Blue, which was a total bitch to write because I didn't want to write music like that at that point. I just wanted to make a puppet show. And then when I presented the music, which is all these sort of angular, ziltoidian sort of arpeggios, the record label's like, we've made all this momentum with you doing Epicloud and Addicted and those sorts of songs. Why can't you do something like that to go along with your stupid fucking puppet show? So I ended up writing Sky Blue, and at first I thought it was going to be easy, but it really wasn't. But it ended up being good because of the sort of process that went into figuring it all out. So here's a song called Midnight Sun. Thank you. so much. Oh, bye. How are you going? You going to pee, or? All right, cool. It's starting right now, though. If it's no? All right, let's talk about him while he's gone, all right? That's a Canadian thing to do, let me tell you, right? Favorite story about this is how I've got such a limited repertoire of jokes. I must have told this one here already. How do you get 30 Canadians out of a swimming pool? Time to get out, guys. We're like, all right, bud, we didn't know where. Is he back? No, it's a different guy. Oh, all right. So what direction should we take now? A little darker, maybe?
Violet.
A little bit? All right, let's see where we at. Turn off the dark. What's that? I'm not very dark. I like to pretend I am, but I'm kind of like an earth tony sort of beige sort of vibe. You know what I mean? That was the biggest problem with strapping in lad. By the end of it, truly I was surrounded by all these tough guys. I remember thinking to myself, like, wow, I can't fight. Like, if shit goes down here tonight, I'm going to get there. I'm going to get the shit kicked out of me. Because I'm fronting too. I'm like, what the way do you think I'm going to show? And I come out and I'm like talking shit on stage. And it's because I'm surrounded by big tough guys. It's easy, right? Then all of a sudden when I leave that, I'm like, I'm actually not that dark. So the answer to the question is, it's not necessarily about the darkness. It's all about the love, right? Right? See that segue? Yeah. You don't even know what song this is.
Love.
Is it? Yeah. Oh, I thought it was something else. Keep me posted, all right? For you, sir.
Wait for breathing.
saw it up here, Deb. You're trying to be creepy, Deb. You're not trying to be earth tone, Deb. Come on. You got a lot invested in holding on to this. That's not creepy either. Well, it's a little creepy. Okay. Wait. Let me end this on a creepy note.
So cool.
sort of gives away. It takes a smoke in the... Siri just turned on my thing there, and she's just talking shit to me while I'm trying to do my thing. So, let me see. Is it working again? It's not. All right. So, Oh, look, a church! Vibration with one of these notes too, and every time I hit it, I'm like, am I sharp? Am I flat? I think I'm sharp. I think I'm flat. No, it's great. So I got another song for you, right? I think somebody had asked for this online today. It's not because I check Twitter every 15 minutes, because that would make me a pathetic guy. No. Somebody asked for this one, so...
numbers are going to drink for your life. So why do you hang on to them? Because if you don't, you got nothing to write about. It's all about being miserable, right? Oh, fuck it. Go back to girl.
Oh,
myself when I said, oh, you guys stopped. I thought, well, that was rude. They did very well. Why would you even bring that up?
Well, I thought it would be funny, but it wasn't. It was just kind of rude.
That's not the Canadian way. The Canadian way is passive-aggressive. That's how we roll. The waitress comes to the table. How's your food? We're like, oh, it's really good. Hey, oh, fuck yeah. I love the chicken wings there, bud. Fucking nice. She gone? She gone? Yeah. This food shit never come out of space. She's a bit of a bitch, isn't she? Mark of my entire career, my friend. When I finally realize that truly and not just intellectually, I'm going to be playing bass in a fucking punk band. I'll tell you right. All right.
Lady of mine, no, I'm trying, but by this boy must die. It's cold inside.
I can't hear anything, right? No, I'm not meaning that in a facetious way. Oh, that! Okay. Just the three people over in this corner near that man, give me a death metal roar. Just the three of you. I'm up here acting like a jackass, and you can't do a death metal roar, you three? Come on. Come on, okay. Oh, okay. How about you, ma'am, in the front? Would you give me a death metal roar? No, okay. So... Everybody, the banana man.
Yeah, I know all these ones. I just don't think I know many of my own songs.
You know, I think it's a bitch play bass. I would love it. Right, yeah. I was saying last night, doing heavy metal is akin to have once acted in a porn movie and then trying to get an authentic acting job. Right? You seen Boogie Nights? When the guy goes in, he's like, you know, I want to do this. He's like, yeah, but you did porn, right? He's like, oh, I got the same with this. I'm like, guys, I got this kind of new agey thing going on. It's kind of outer space country theme because I'm in my 40s and I'm over it. Blah, 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 blah. They're like, yeah, but you did metal, so fuck yeah. Is my own property, and if you don't keep it to yourself, my friend, I'm talking about your penis. You can say whatever you want. I'm a tolerant folk, but if you don't keep your penis to the self there, everybody's going to point it out and say, oh, it's just like an uncooked prawn in sort of a used SOS pad. I don't know if you have those over here, do you? No, SOS pads are like the wire or wool thing that you have beside the sink that rusts and smells like shit. That with a uncooked prawn hanging out of it. That's my penis. And restraining yourself, and the thing that ends with straining that probably isn't cun or reed. My friends, this is a song called Coast.
Oh.
is totally not that. Keep that in mind. Ha ha! It's all about life. Another segue. you've shown me 10 minutes is what you're saying? All right. Oh, Paul, has it been that long already? Really? Okay, I got a good last song, all right? But I'm going to stay up here, and if you guys want to take photos, or I'll sign anything. It doesn't matter, as long as it's not boobs, because then my wife's going to see it, and then I get shit. It sucks. Every time. Trust me, it doesn't happen often, right? There you go, signs boobs off of you. But no, they come up there. There was a girl the other night, she's like, sign my boob. And so I signed like up there with an arrow. Because like, last time I even got near a nipple, it was on Twitter, and my wife was like, oh yeah? And that resulted in the prawn being off limits. So. Which is my motivation in life, by the way. So. Okay, in all seriousness here, really, and I, even with this radio talk show DJ voice, in all seriousness tonight, guys, in all seriousness, thank you for allowing me to come here. I really, really, really enjoy being in Scotland, and I really, really enjoy your energy. Thank you so much for all the support, guys. I've seen a lot of you a lot of times. Thank you for coming back. And if you're new to it, it usually isn't like this, you know? And if you think it's good, then yes, it's like this all the time. And if you think this sucks, it's way better, so you should come to the show, right? One last song, guys. Thank you so much again. Like, really, I mean, it's hard for me to overstate that. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Yes, thank you, Joe. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Can't wait to meet you all after the show, all right? Here's the last song for you. It's called Slow Me Down, all right?
It's so easy when you
you so much, my friend. Please have a great night. Please take care of yourselves. Give your folks a call if they're still around. Tell them you love them. See you guys. Thank you for being here.
Stay, and I'll see you guys after the show.
Okay?
Awesome. Of course.